face the things that we're afraid of, right? Because we're like, you know, people are in general just kind of scared right now. And I mean, I'm scared also. But if we start to face it and we start to break it down so that we can understand that, okay, so we're scared, and I'm gonna tell a story. A couple of years ago, I was walking down Church Street in Tribeca, and there was a beautiful woman. I mean, a beautiful woman, finely dressed in her 20s, and she was choking, like, I mean, beautiful, choking, walking into the traffic. And she was just walking down the street, and choking, and walking into the traffic. And I mean, beautiful, like stunning, right? And the reason why I bothered to say that she was stunning is because I think that it kind of brings us all in, right? Because we're all kind of like beautiful people, and we think like, oh, well, someone's gonna come and help us, right? Like it's, you know, like there's gonna be someone that's gonna come through for us. And she was walking into the traffic with her head slung back and walking into the traffic, like as if she's just gonna walk into the traffic and the car is moving out of the way and she's gonna get killed. And I saw this, I was with my husband, and I stopped her and I pulled her down and I said, oh, it's okay, it's okay. And I talked her down, and you know, and she was, you know, choking on her tongue, maybe she was having a seizure or epileptic seizure or something like that. And there was a pastor there that was with her, and he said that he had followed her for 30 blocks since Bellevue. She was walking into the traffic with her head slung back, choking on her tongue for 30 blocks, and nobody stopped her. I did.
No, the pastor.
Why? That was my question. That was
like he's filming you the whole time, but he's watching her.
No, I'm kidding.
Like when people are filming these things, it's like, why don't they save that person?
He had the best intentions in his heart, right? Because he was like, oh, I've been following her, and you know, and I'm like trying to safeguard her, like an angel of some sort, right? And I brought her down, and they called for the hospital, and they came and they took her. And the thing that I thought at that moment is, wow, she went through so many neighborhoods in New York City. She went from Bellevue, where she was admitted and then somehow got out, down to Church Street and Chambers, and nobody stopped her. And what that means is that people were laughing, right? Because people are like, ah, like that's really funny, like somebody's like choking on their fucking tongue, walking into the street, like gonna kill themselves. Or they were freaked out, right? People get scared. And nobody came to help her. And I think that that really says a lot about our community in New York City. Because I was also there on 9/11, and on 9/11, my husband and I live in a building that was directly next to the World Trade Center, and we were on the 34th floor with an unobstructed view. And I saw the plane coming at us. And the plane came at us and it went into the tower, and I watched the whole thing happen in real time. And after that, people were very nice, right? People were so caring and loving in New York City. But when people were watching somebody that could have killed themselves, they watched. They watched that woman walk into traffic for 30 fucking blocks. And what that says to me is that sure, if we all go through a catastrophe together, then at the end of it, we'll all come together and be really nice to each other and really caring and loving and supportive, and that's a beautiful thing. But what about if you're watching somebody who's like going into their own death and it's frightening to you? Do you understand what I'm saying? How many people are going to step out and protect those people? And that's something that I think that we all have to think about, because that is something that we're dealing with at this moment in time. How much are we willing to do to protect ourselves and the people that we love and to stand up for justice? And that's a question that I think we all have to ask ourselves. and for a woman to walk so many blocks and to walk into traffic and to really like be putting her life at, you know, just her life is at risk. And people watching just to me just said so much about New York City. I mean, that was 30 fucking blocks. 30 blocks, that's going through a lot of different neighborhoods in New York City. So, you know, yeah. So how much are we willing to watch? I think that's a question, right? How much are we willing to observe and to say, oh, well, that just happened. Oh, well, that just happened. Oh, those people just got killed. Oh, those people just got killed. How many more people are going to just get killed? So the thing is that what that leads me to is, well, what can we do about it, right? Because we all feel so helpless in this kind of overwhelming situation. What can we really do? What can we do to save ourselves? And that's a question that needs to start to be addressed in a very real way that becomes prevalent in our culture and with our people and in New York City. Because let me tell you something, New York City, man, I mean, I just literally, like, beautiful woman, finely dressed, I mean, gorgeous, walking right into the cars and nobody stopped her. So this is something to be said about our tolerance of what we can witness and not do anything about. So so this show that I am so happy to have put together from the inside of my soul and to kind of express so many fears that I have and so many concerns that just rave in my mind is really an activation of some sort for people like everybody in this room right now, right? Because this is the Wake the Fuck Up show. So anyone in the room is kind of awake in a certain way, right? Because you're not gonna come to the Wake the Fuck Up show and not be a little awake. Because you're gravitating to something that is awake. So we're all people that can do something. And if we give up and we become numb to everything that's going on in the world, we're gonna be in a really fucked up place. And we're already in a really fucked up place, but you know, so let's get it together. You know, let's pull it together as much as we possibly can. Every single person is a voice. I mean, I don't want to be like a fucking preacher. I don't even want to be doing politics. I'd rather be talking about my feelings. So much rather be talking about my feelings right now, about other things. But really, truly, like, we need everybody. I do have a organization called Nonpartisan Peace, which I normally don't talk about, but I will talk about tonight because it's the closing night. And it's Nonpartisan Peace, and it's an organization that is 100% for peace. Thank you so much for being here. We're gonna do a couple of performances this evening. And I'm just happy to have you guys here. And let's all just step it up. Let's just step it up in every single possible way that we possibly can. And, you know, protect our safety and our health and our lives, because I really believe that there's something at stake here. And I totally would not be here tonight if it weren't, if I didn't feel that way so sincerely and truly. So, so thank you. And then I'm going to be doing a song with Mikey and Emmy, so please stick around and we'll do that.
All right.